שגריר יוצא דופן אחרי שהוא התפנה מהחגיגות בשבוע שעבר של חנוכת השגרירות. הוא מתפנה לארח אותנו לרעיון בלשכה החדשה שלו בשגרירות. זה רעיון שתואם מראש, אבל הוא בהחלט מנצל את ההזדמנות כדי להבהיר שהתקרית הזאת אתמול הייתה מבוכה גדולה מבחינתו עם התמונה. בהחלט מגיע בעיתוי מאוד לא נוח מבחינת האמריקאים, מכיוון שהם מנסים בכל זאת לראות אם אפשר להחזיר את הפלסטינים לשולחן כשהם יניחו את התוכנית בעוד כמה חודשים. ובהקשר הזה מעניין לשמוע שהשגריר פרידמן אומר בעצם שהוא לא בטוח שאבו מאזן באמת פרטנר לעשות איתו שלום, אבל נתניהו מצד שני הוא בהחלט האדם שהם סומכים עליו. ועוד דבר מעניין, השאלה מה יקרה אם מישהו יגיד לא לנשיא. ישראל, אנחנו מבינים, תוכל להגיד לא אם היא תגיד כן, אבל הפלסטינים יצטרכו לשלם בכיס כמו שטראמפ אוהב. וגם בשורה לגבי הוויזה, כי זה בהחלט על השולחן שלנו, בוא תראה. זהו זה?
את ראית הנוף? איזה יופי, נכון?
כן.
מאוד מרגש, נכון?
האמנת שתהיה פה ככה בשגרירות החדשה?
קיוויתי שזה יהיה, בעזרת השם. עכשיו זה לא חלום עוד.
אם יש מישהו שיכול לקחת קרדיט על העברת השגרירות האמריקנית לירושלים, זה לא ספק האיש הזה. דיוויד פרידמן, השגריר האמריקני בישראל, לא לחינם השם שלו מופיע על הלוח מתחת לזה של הנשיא.
נו, אז בסוף לדונלד טראמפ יש גם בניין בירושלים.
כן.
A Trump building in Jerusalem.
yeah, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. Very proud of it. He's very proud of it. I made him one of these for the Oval Office. I paid for it myself. I made one for him and one for me. So I have one in my house, and he has one in the Oval Office because we're so proud of it.
שבוע אחרי הטקס החגיגי שהכל כבר כאן שוב שקט, השגריר פרידמן מזמין אותנו למשרד החדש שלו כדי להבהיר, בכל זאת התחיל עידן חדש.
Ambassador Friedman, thank you so much for having us in your new office.
Thank you, Donna. I'm so happy you could join us. I think you're one of the first journalists to visit the Jerusalem Embassy, and welcome.
Thank you. Have you settled in?
מרגיש בבית?
אני מרגיש באמת הכי בבית.
Now, in hindsight, after seeing the split screen on the day of the inauguration last week, maybe it would have been wiser to choose a different date, not do it on the Nakba date.
I don't know that there would have been any other date that would not have provoked what we saw, because I think Hamas was going to take advantage of this opening to make as much mayhem as they could have. So I don't know if there was a better date.
But at the end of the day, you were very clear in saying that this decision doesn't work against peace, but it enhances peace. And if you think where we were in December and where we are now, the Palestinian Authority has walked away from the table and hasn't come back.
They're at this point not at the table.
Do you still think they will come back?
I think that if we're able to propose something over the next few months that offers a better, more optimistic, more promising future to the Palestinian people. I believe in democracy. I believe that if people are interested in this, the leadership will have no choice but to pursue it.
Do you believe Abu Mazen is still a partner?
Look, I'm certainly concerned and disturbed by some of the things he said, some of the things he's done. But this is a decision for the Palestinian people. We don't pick fights with Palestinian leadership. We try to support the Palestinian
people. Although they try to pick a fight with you. Even personally, he insulted you.
David Friedman. قال هون هم يبنون في أرضهم. ابن الكلب يبنون في أرضهم.
I have a very thick skin. It'd take a lot more than that to insult me.
But do you think he is the leader who can rise up to the occasion and make the compromise needed?
It's really, I don't know.
And Prime Minister Netanyahu, you think from what you see he can deliver?
Everything I've seen about him, and as you say, I have worked very closely with him, I think he's an extraordinary leader, and I think if he believes that we're moving in a direction that is in the best interest of the Israeli people, I have no doubt that he
has. And he will make the concessions needed, because the president has been very clear and said that both parties are gonna have to do things they don't like.
If the Prime Minister thinks that what's being proposed is in the best interest of Israel in its totality, I have no doubt that he will move in that direction.
But will there be a price for saying no to the president?
It depends. If respect the rights of, certainly the rights of Israel as a sovereign nation to you know, speak to us candidly about what they can and can't live with, and we would respect that. I think if the Palestinians don't sit down, refuse to come to the table, yeah, I can't imagine that would be well received in the White House.
Well, when they say that the United States has lost its you know, role as an honest broker, in a way, how can you blame him? Yesterday, you are standing and you're presented a picture of the Temple Mount without the Arab mosque and with the Jewish temple in it. So they can say, I mean, are these guys going to be honest? Are they going to listen to our needs?
I was more mortified than anyone else, than any Palestinian, when I saw a picture of myself next to that poster. Somebody just shoved it in front of me, took a picture, and of course, that's unacceptable to me, and the United States respects the status quo on the Haram al-Sharif. So that's a really unfortunate thing, and I feel terrible that people might have reacted to that the way they did. In terms of the role of the United States, we are an honest broker. We are incredibly close to Israel. We have an important relationship there. They're one of our most important allies. But that doesn't mean that we cannot help to bring the parties to a peace deal.
So you still believe it's possible, personally? Would you want to bet?
I'm pretty confident.
Really?
I am, yeah.
But that's a good optimist note. But, you know, talking about the alliance between the United States and Israel, President Trump has proven that he doesn't hesitate to take bold actions. Will he allow Jonathan Pollard to come to Israel?
You know, I really don't know. It's not a discussion I've ever had with him, so...
But is it on the table?
It's not on my table, but it may be very much on someone else's table. It's just not something that I've dealt with personally.
Let's talk about Iran. Could Israel rely on this administration if and when it came to a military option to stop Iran from getting a nuclear weapon?
You're really going to have to ask the secretary or the president. I just am not the one to answer that question.
And regarding Syria?
I'm working with the Israelis all the time to make sure that their views are articulated to the White House and back and forth. I think the relationship between the U.S. and Israel with regard to Syria, very, very closely aligned.
So I finally, when I think about Israelis, they really want to know, are you a bearer of good news when it comes to the visa? Can you tell us that the Via de la Rosa for the visa is about to change?
I can just tell you that we're working on it. Look, it involves the Department of Homeland Security. It involves the Department of State. We're trying to do as much as we can, as fast as we can, but I don't have any more updates than that.
But is it something that you would want to see?
I'd love to see it, but it obviously requires compliance with a host of laws, and we're trying to get to the point where that can be accomplished.
Ambassador Freeman, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much.